Paquito Navarrón, Juan LeBron are new official couple. After four seasons, Paquito and LeBron are playing together again. In 2019, they became world number one. So what will happen in 2024? What are the strengths and weaknesses of this new couple? Hello to all players, I'm Pablo and I welcome you to a new 4-set. 86 days ago, the final of the Master Final was played. In that match, Paquito Navarrón, Fede Chingoto defeated Juan LeBron and Alejandro Galán. If you had been told after that match that both couples were going to mix, would you have believed it? It seems unbelievable, but it's real. Subscribe to the channel if you love this new couple, Paquito and LeBron. Paquito and LeBron are gonna play together again because yes, they already did it in 2019. In 2018, LeBron began to stand out among the best players in the world playing on the left side of the court. He will finish the season with Juan Martín Díaz, exactly with the partner with whom Paquito will start the season. But how did Paquito and LeBron end up playing together in 2019?
Eso fue de locos. Eso fue de locos. Y dice, yo, tú, ¿cómo te ves? Pago conmigo a la derecha. Y yo, bueno, yo me quedé un poco impactado, ¿sabes? Un poco impactado y al principio no sabía qué contestarle, ¿sabes?
¿Por qué?
Hombre, porque yo estaba un poco acojonado, no te voy a mentir, por pasarme a la derecha. Pero también sabía que si lo hacía bien, entrenando bien, confiaba mucho en mí mismo y digo, si me pongo a entrenar, no me voy de vacaciones y hago lo que tengo que hacer, yo creo que lo puedo hacer muy bien.
In that 2019 season, Paquito Navarrón, Juan LeBron started very well. Out of the first 8 tournaments, they managed to win 4 titles and reach 3 finals, with they lost all of them against Sanjo and Maxi, the ones who were number ones. With such a good start, Paquito and LeBron were quickly placed with serious options to be number one, and then the crisis in their game began. They would go 5 tournaments without reaching the finals. They even decided to leave Ramiro Choya as a coach and look for a solution in Marcelo El Negro. And they would get it, because in Brazil, with 2 tournaments left to finish the season, they would proclaim number one in the world. In this way, they became the first players born in Spain to be world number one. And in that 2019 season, they not only managed to be number one, but they were the precursors of the paddle that reigns today. A much more offensive and fast paddle. But how is it possible that a couple with so much success decided to separate? Well, as in every story, there are 2 versions.
Con Paco todo iba genial y de repente, ¿qué pasa?
Bueno, son circunstancias de la pareja. Que pasan, que pueden pasar durante el año. Pero es un tema, Pablo, tío. O sea, las cosas como son.
Según el número 2.
Las cosas como son, tío. O sea, hicimos un temporadón y sí que es verdad que, bueno, tuvimos ahí un pequeño bache que no supimos valorar esos resultados. Que para mí, es verdad que al fin y al cabo, él y yo somos muy ganadores, somos muy ambiciosos, muy motivadores, queremos más y, ostras, es verdad que nos afectó, yo creo, por eso, porque queríamos más y teníamos mucha ansiedad por conseguir eso. Entonces, no supimos valorar esos resultados, a lo mejor que habían sido buenos, pero a la vez nos hacían ver que no eran tan buenos. Y como ahora, en una entrevista, que yo dije, creo que estar en una semifinal, creo que es muy bueno, ¿sabes? Y por eso dije, creo que hay que valorar todo ese trabajo.
Para mí, tomamos la decisión a mitad de temporada, porque empezamos muy bien el año, luego vinieron los malos resultados y yo creo que no supimos gestionar esos malos resultados. En vez de decir, oye, nosotros hemos dado un nivelazo, creemos que podemos volver a jugar a ese nivel, simplemente hay que reajustar un par de toques y hacer un proyecto de largo plazo. Yo creo que nos pusimos un poco nerviosos y dijimos, uff, esto no ha terminado de cuajar, y nos separamos. Y a final de año volvimos a jugar muy bien, a ser número uno. Entonces yo creo que la decisión ya estaba tomada y conseguimos el número uno, y ya luego nos miramos y dijimos, bueno, ya es lo que hay. Y así fue, eso es lo que pasó, que tomamos la decisión en un momento malo de la pareja. Y luego, pues, circunstancias de la vida, nos pusimos a volver a jugar muy bien, pero la decisión ya estaba tomada.
After that decision, their paths followed different ways. LeBron will continue at the top of the world ranking with Ale Galán for 3 seasons, but however, Paquito's way has been really different. He will play in 2020 with Pablo Lima not reaching his expectations, and he will do the same with Martito Dineno in 2021 and 2022, with whom he was only 1 match away from being number 1. After that, he will try to play on the right with Juan Tello in a risky experiment that didn't work out well. And finally, he will play 2023 with Fede Chingoto reaching 6 finals and win 1 title, the Master Final. 2 very different bats, so why didn't Paco last longer with his teammates?
¿Y por qué Paquito Navarro no aguanta más de 1 año con un compañero?
No Paquito Navarro, yo creo que salvo los que ganan, número 1, y a veces ni aun así, todo el mundo cambia. Es nuestro deporte, cada día se hace más impaciente, cada vez los resultados mandan más sobre las parejas, entonces no es Paquito Navarro, yo creo que todas las parejas del circuito salvo 2 y los que ganan, y te digo, incluso a veces ni los que ganan, cambian de pareja. ¿Es lo ideal y es lo que y es lo bueno y es lo que hay que hacer? No digo ni que sí ni que no, es simplemente la época que nos ha, lo que pasa.
After such a long time, Paquito and LeBron have really played together again. Actually, they will do it at least 3 times. Pre-season 2023 at the BNK Padel Open in Kuwait, where they played against Coello and Tapia, and the most important, in the finals against Argentina in the World Padel Championships in 2021 and 2022. In 2021, they will win against Dineno and Bella being world champions, and in 2022, they will win against Tapia and Chingoto, although Argentina will finally become champions. The reason for the union of Paco and LeBron happened last week at the Mayor of Doha. After Galán-LeBron's match against Garrido and Yanguas, Galán decided to leave the project together with LeBron. With Ale's decision, Juan was left without a partner, so he had to look for an emergency solution to be able to play the P2 in Puerto Cabello. That tournament will be played with Momo González, so Paquito and LeBron will debut as a couple in April in Brussels to play a week later in Seville, Paquito's Navarro's home. LeBron confessing Marca the following: "Now it's time to play Mexico, Venezuela, and from there look for an ambitious project that allows me to go for the high goals that I always set for myself with my new partner. And I have no doubt that Juan's goal is to be number one again. And having been number one in the past with Paco, logic says that it is not a bad decision. Because how did Paco feel about one day playing with LeBron again?"
Por supuesto, ¿por qué no? ¿Por qué no? A mí LeBron creo que es un jugador que tiene muchísimos años por delante. Es difícil porque ya te digo, yo ya tengo cada vez más años, LeBron va a tener la novia que quiera en esto del pádel y no lo sé, pero yo nunca digo nunca y nunca te digo con este jugador no volvería a jugar. Yo volvería a jugar con... Es que da igual, o sea, con cualquiera. Para mí el pádel es mi trabajo, o sea, no hay nada que me pueda tomar personal. Y con LeBron además me llevo muy bien, creo que es un crack, creo que tiene un fondo de corazón impresionante. Y ¿por qué no?
Stop for a second and think, don't you consider that someone is missing in this whole story? Sanjo Gutiérrez is, without a doubt, the most damaged of all this story, and I feel very sorry for him. With Paquito's decision, Sanjo finds himself without a partner. Actually, in the 2 tournaments that Paquito and Sanjo played together, they lost in the first one in Riyadh, but managed to reach the semifinals in Doha. Who will Sanjo play with? Will he break a new couple or will he play at the left side of the court? In any case, let's analyze the strengths of Paquito Navarro and Juan LeBron as a couple. And in the first place, in my opinion, is the experience. Unlike Galán and Chingoto, Paquito and LeBron know each other and they know each other very well. Not only that they know each other, but they have had 4 years to mature as a players. So they are not gonna be the same Paquito and LeBron as they were in 2019. Nowadays, there are much more experienced players who have won many more titles. In fact, Paco helped Juan in the past to understand paddle better.
Con Paquito, te tengo que decir que el tipo mentalmente también me ayudó mucho y a entender también el pádel un poco más de lo que yo venía jugando al pádel, ¿eh? Me ayudó también a entender un poco más el pádel en ciertas circunstancias del partido.
On the other hand, this couple is magical. They are two of the most skilled players in the whole tour. And in fact, they are the founders of Padel Trotters, so they don't lack skills. But if there is one thing that stands out above the rest in both players, is the candela. If we have reached this point in the story, it's precisely because LeBron is a hot player on court. Paquito is too, and that candela, if well managed, can be very dangerous for his opponents. But of course, it can also be a problem. So the main weakness of the couple can also be the candela. Because if they separated in the past, as Juan said, it was for not knowing how to enjoy the moments and being so self-demanding. In the same way, the pressure now on the couple is different. In 2019, Paquito was the star and Juan was a promise. The situation has changed and Juan comes from being number one with Galán for 3 seasons. Will they both know how to deal with that pressure and could it take its toll on them again like in 2019? Another weak point of the couple has to do with the physique. Paquito's smash and court coverage compared to Ale's is less. And in the same way, LeBron's physique compared to 2019 is worse because of the injuries. Now he's not as offensive or explosive as he used to be. Surely they are going to adapt a similar way of playing, but penalize it in that aspect. What results will Paquito and LeBron achieve as a couple? Well, without a doubt, they are candidates to be number one. They were, and their level has not become worse, but has improved. If they manage to apply the candela to the couple in the good aspect, they are very dangerous. Something very positive for LeBron, especially at this moment, is the public's love for Paquito. Paquito is without a doubt the most loved player in all the stadiums where he plays. But the question arises, are LeBron and Paquito better than Galán and Chingoto? And my only answer is that I wanna see that match now. Can we get more likes on this video compared to Galán and Chingoto's one? It is impossible to predict what will happen this season with so many changes. Will Coello and Tapia and the Super Pibes be the most outstanding couples? Will any new couple be able to reach that level? Thank you very much for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next one.